Johnson & Johnson, and all of those who stand to profit immensely from global suffering. While millions continue to suffer in India and across the globe, lobbyists in Washington, D.C. have warned in private. They've been warning that waiving intellectual property rights could allow countries like India, China, and Russia to exploit research. They've been saying that it could even be used to create vaccines and therapeutics for conditions like cancer and heart problems in the future. Now, how terrible would that be, huh? How awful is that? We need to identify the core problem. After all, to be radical simply means grasping things by the root. The problem is the entire system that places profit before people. A system that only serves the interests of private capital, that makes all of its decisions based only upon what will make the rich richer, what will make capital grow. A system known as capitalism. What we really need is a system that prioritizes human lives and human potential. A system that makes all of its decisions based only upon the well-being and the needs of the society. Socialism. I want to leave you all here today on a note of revolutionary optimism, because we know it's always darkest before the dawn.
That's right.
I want to give the example of Kerala, an Indian state governed by the socialist left-front government. Over the past year, Kerala has invested in increasing its oxygen capacity. Compared to April 2020 of last year, Kerala had the capacity to produce 50 liters per minute of oxygen. The same time, April of this year, they're producing 1,250 liters of oxygen, a surplus that is helping the rest of the country. In Kerala, treatment for COVID-19 is provided completely free of cost by the government, along with free meals to patients. The state government has also fixed the prices for COVID treatments at private hospitals to ensure that they don't engage in price gouging. According to the Union Health Ministry, it's like a central department, there has been 100% utilization of vaccines in Kerala without any wastage. Unlike in other states, unlike here, where in Brockton at the start of the vaccine, hundreds of doses went to waste, and hundreds continue to. Free food kits have been delivered to 8.8 million families that are still served by the government so that nobody goes hungry during a global pandemic. In socialist Cuba, which does not have rigid intellectual property laws, they have just entered phase 3 trials of their own vaccine, the first one in Latin America, one which they have promised to give out for free, especially to the global south, to the poor, the oppressed, the darker nations of this world. What we really need is a systems level change to combat the COVID catastrophe. We need to recognize that these problems can only be solved at a system-wide level, and that we have the potential to radically reorganize our society. We must be bold.
Yes.
We must dare to invent the future.
Yes.
We need to organize ourselves here in the heart of world imperialism with a firmly anti-capitalist politics. with a firmly socialist politics that prioritizes the working class and prioritizes oppressed peoples.
Yes!
We must organize ourselves on a firmly internationalist and firmly anti-imperialist politics, because we know that this is just a part of a much larger global struggle to liberate humanity. We can have a system where we aren't helpless against poverty and pandemics, where we can allocate real resources to our problems, not just thoughts and prayers.
Yes, right.
A better world is possible. Socialism is possible.
Yeah.
And thank you all very much for being here. Follow the Boston South Asian Coalition on social media if you're a person of South Asian descent or just of a progressive leaning. Please do join us, because we need every person.